vomiting and had a very swollen stomach. So late last night, she was flown here to Perth to this hospital behind me where she remains in a stable condition. Now, they say that she was treated in hospital on Christmas Island, but her friends say she needed specific tests that she wasn't able to receive on Christmas Island, hence why she's been taken here to Perth to get those tests. So it's expected she'll get them today. Now, her friends say she has a very complex medical history, and today just shows all the more reason why her and her family shouldn't be kept in detention on Christmas Island.
And Evelyn, just give us some background to the case concerning this family.
Absolutely. Many people would be familiar with the Tamil family. Priya, the mother, and her husband were living in rural Queensland in a town called Biloela. They were living and working there for a number of years before they got put in detention in Melbourne in March 2018. Then late last year, they were taken to Christmas Island off the coast of Australia, where they were granted an injunction to stop this deportation, and they have been there since. So her husband and two children remain on Christmas Island.
It's been a long wait there. What are the concerns that advocates for the family have?
They're quite concerned about her husband and children who remain on Christmas Island. The fact that they've been separated, obviously their mother or partner is sick at the moment and she's been in pain for a number of weeks. So to be separated from her is quite distressing, is what the friends tell me. And they're just really worried about her health and say it's all the more reason why she shouldn't be kept on Christmas Island because of her very complex medical history. Home Affairs say that they can't comment on individual cases, though, Miriam.
Our reporter Evelyn Manfield with the latest there from Perth.